and it's time to play away. Here's our foursome. Four players going for the title. Nick Suzuki, Clayton Keller, Jason Robertson, and Johnny Gaudreau. And on the tee first is the Montreal captain, the youngest in team history, Nick Suzuki. See what he got, Michael.
He got the coolest gloves of all of them. Well, look at this.
That's clean.
Out the box.
Oh, with roll. On edge.
Oh, don't get too close to the water. Look at. Wow.
You do have to be concerned a bit about the water on this tee shot, so Nick is happy.
It's a nice layup.
So Nick says, nice layup, Michael. Do you think he was trying to drive this par four and one over that dangerous island green?
You hear how disappointed his voice sounds there, but it's into the wind. As a caddy, we're not making birdie from the water. Those pucks don't float.
All right. Up next, Clayton Keller. Maybe the best golfer of the four if they were using, you know, golf balls and golf clubs. The 24-year-old grew up in Missouri, and this one's clean as well. Okay, don't forget, the tiebreaker for the competition is the longest drive. So this is an important part of the competition.
Very important, especially after seeing these first two shots. They're in great position.
This is a 140-yard hole we are playing. Drive it just before the water, and then hopefully get your approach on the green. Here's Jason Robertson, the young American from California, having an awesome year for Dallas. Oh, we got a worm burner.
Yell, run.
You don't want to get it too high.
Yeah, wind cheater.
That's what happened. I didn't want to get too high, and then it just goes on the ground.
Jason just found out that pucks don't run when they get on grass. He's worried.
Yeah, he's concerned about the approach, but
kind of embarrassed.
Old Nick Suzuki gave him some reassurance there. So our final tee shot from Johnny Gaudreau, Johnny Hockey. See what he got. Oh, nice one. That is clean.
Down the left side.
Pure.
Man.
Not quite as far as Nick, it appears. Boy, that's some clean sauce, Michael.
And he got that up into the air quickly. Off of that hockey stick.
Marinara on that thing.
Yeah. He's my favorite because he's the one I can look in the eye.
Golf clap with hockey gloves.
No one heard it.
So it is Nick Suzuki. He owns the tiebreaker now. Johnny Gaudreau, Clayton Keller, and yes, still away, your boy, Jason Robertson. He's concerned about this approach.
I think the shot's a little further than it looks over the water. You definitely want to get it there, so I think you pretty much got to give it your all. The pin's in the right side, keeping it to the left. I think, as you saw before, might roll to the right, so give yourself maybe aim at the edge of the bunker, left of the pin. I think it's going to play a little further than it looks, so give it a rip, and you got your mulligan if
Can't
needed.
Can't believe so. I got to go first.
Send it up there.
All right, so there's PGA Tour player Corey Connors, the Canadian who loves hockey.
Yes.
Giving Jason some advice. Can he clear the water?
Oh! He did it! Man, into the wind, just cleared, barely.
He's happy about it.
That almost didn't make it. I thought that was going to be, like, near the pin.
Well, because it died at the beginning.
It looked like it was flying. It looked like it was flying far, but
you're right about how far
it like, I think the depth-wise, it plays longer.
Apparently, hockey pucks are affected by wind just like golf balls are.
You see, it's kind of on edge. It was kind of frisbee into the right.
It's a lot easier than my shot.
And like a bad caddy, you heard one of the players when it was in the air go, go in.
It looks like it was going
to
land
right beside it. Yeah. It died, but I'm still happy with mine.
Okay, so Clayton Keller now with the approach.
I like that little last move at the end. I love it. Bringing it in lower.
It gives him some rhythm. And oh, that's a fortuitous bounce to the right.
How you can spin like that on a puck to go that way?
It's all luck.
What?
You don't know what edge you're going to fall on. Comes in again. This is just perfect. Look at that. Little side sauce. Side sauce. So he's got 20 feet, it looks like, for birdie. Robertson's a good 40-footer for birdie. Let's see what Gaudreau and Suzuki can do.
They switched the pucks. There they took the one away. You can mark it.
Can I be a little jealous of that hair?
The flow, it's gorgeous.
Yeah.
It's luscious. Here's Johnny. Eyeing down the flagstick. Oh, he takes it in low and firm, and Oh, that's a skipper, but he bounces back.
See, now he was trying, like in golf, to hit that little two hop and stop.
Mm-hmm.
But when you do that with a hockey puck and have that much side spin.
All on the green. I got to shoot mine last first again.
And then here's one hop.
Boom.
Oh, looking for the stop, but.
Bam. So here comes our long drive. Going last, Nick Suzuki. No problem clearing the water. Now he's thinking to stick this.
Yeah.
Here we
go. He's in full control. And I love how they can't help but do the little hockey move. That's their waggle.
That is their waggle. Correct.
Bringing it in low as well.
He gets a front skip.
Is that closest, too?
I think so.
Look at that look on his face, Michael. He wants this.
You know how much those other golf hockey guys are mad right now?
I want to play in this.
That one hop and stop is exactly what
Gaudreau was looking for.
He was
right?
Looking for that same thing and didn't get it.
No. Yeah, look, he's waving to the crowd.
The only righty.
I'm not back. From this angle, it's even worse.
So now we approach the green for four birdie putts.
Those are four good looking shots. I want to know which shot was the most nerve-wracking for everyone.
Mine was pretty nerve-wracking. I thought mine was going to be a bit short, but got a nice bounce up there on the green.
Yeah, I'd probably say the second shot. I think, you know, just going over the water, and we didn't really get any practice shots over the water, so just kind of trying to figure that out.
Probably the drive for me. I don't shoot the puck very far, but got a good bounce.
Short guys aren't the longest off the tee.
Yeah.
Robo?
It's got to be mine. I mean, I had to set the tone for the second shot, kind of gauge where it's at. Obviously, it was the worst one, but, I mean, they can thank me for that.
Unfortunately, you get to hear those four words again. You're still away.
Still away.
Still away. Who will be the champion this year? Well, much more from the links and the beach at the 2023 All-Star Skills. Welcome back to the thrilling conclusion of the 2023 Chipotle Pitch and Puck. All the players have reached the green in regulation. Jason Robertson away about 35 feet, Michael.
I would not say this is a good-looking putting setup.
Oh, he goes with a slap shot. Surprising move from the young Californian.
Wrist shot off the tee, slap shot on the green. Look at his face. He knows.
Jason's officially rattled.
Yeah, mercy.
Mercy.
There's no mercy.
Calling for
what are you calling
caddy?
Me for? I got nothing.
Yeah, he wanted to read from
you. Where am I putting here? Where am I aiming?
It looks like it just left of...
Just left a little bit?
Nick's mark, yeah. It should break a little to the right.
All right.
But,
all right.
So Johnny Gaudreau gets last-minute instructions from Corey Connors, PGA Tour player, won the Valero Texas Open back in 2019. Oops. Whoa. Makes contact. Wait, nope. USGA rules. That's fine. It was a practice stroke. Left or right? Goes big.
Now Nick was just watching that. Yeah. Now he got a free read.
Like he's in a scramble. You did that on the tour. You better watch out.
You probably getting a
look at Nick getting
strokes.
A read.
Yeah.
You see his mark right there halfway to the hole.
Yep.
That's not good.
So he knows it's left or right now.
Pick it up.
Clayton Keller.
All right.
Another birdie putt about 15 feet, Michael.
I'm going to do my golfer voice here down the hill. Should break a little right.
Oh!
Got the lip!
Oh, so close. So close. He thought he had it. Here it is again.
I gave him the read on that and told him right there it's downhill.
Has not tied his shoes. It didn't pay off there. So it all comes down to this, Michael. Nick Suzuki has a chance to be the champion. And if he makes this, he wins not only pride and bragging rights, but free Chipotle for a year. There's a lot on the line.
You know how big I'd be at next year's training camp?
Here it is.
For the
bird.
Yes, sir.
Perfect.
Winner, winner, Chipotle dinner. And look at the pride on this young man's face. It's better than the Stanley Cup. He has won. The Chipotle Pitch and Puck Contest.
Are we finishing out? Or?
Oh, there he is. A wave to the crowd, a win, which includes an interview with our own Michael Collins. Michael, take it away.
Zooks, no one expected a birdie on this par four. We're going to have to start calling you Birdie Man, but you were the one guy who said, hey, after we're done, can I go play golf out there? Did you expect this?
No, I probably wouldn't make a birdie with a real golf club. So, I'm just happy that I got a good roll on it. Corey gave me a good read, and I was able to put in the hole.
which shot meant the most to you?
Oh, the putt, for sure. I was a bit nervous. The guys were, it's tough to read the screen, but yeah, I was just tried to put a good roll on it and broke right in the hole.
Most importantly now, anytime you play any other of your fellow NHL competitors out on the golf course, is this gonna now mean you gotta give them more strokes?
It might be. It's my first birdie of the year, so we'll take that and try to keep growing my game.
A win's a win. Congratulations.
All right, thank you.